Hi, my name is Crystal Moore, and I've been planted at 5F Church since 2021. I met Apostle through a video that was going around online of a woman being delivered from the spirit of mute. After watching this video, I was hearing the lies of the enemy, saying that she wasn't real, but I rejected those lies and I eventually started watching all the videos. She came to Traveler, South Carolina, December 15th, 2021. And me, my husband, and a friend of mine at the time, we went. When we went, I renounced a lot of things, but in particular, I renounced the spirit of gluttony and the spirit of addiction. When I left, I didn't manifest or anything, but when I left, I just left believing that God had moved powerfully. When I went back home, I noticed that I was able to do things that I couldn't do prior. I used to try to lose weight prior or exercise, and I couldn't. But now I could push the plate. I started working out, just using things in my house. And these are all things that I couldn't do before. Fast forward, 5 months had passed, and at my 5 month mark, I had already lost 75 pounds. During this period, I felt like God was placing on my heart that He wanted me to have another child. A little over a month later, I found out I was pregnant. I got pregnant, I was fine at first. And a little after that, I'm still watching Apostles' videos, still receiving teachings. I end up starting to get sick. I end up having an at-home nurse, and I was just sick. I couldn't do anything for myself. But during this time, I was remembering Apostles' teachings and how she once was speaking on how we shouldn't complain in the wilderness because that's what stagnated the Israelites. So I took this seriously, even though I was sick. Like, so sick. I've never been this sick before. I've been sick my other pregnancies, but this one was out of this world. So it was times throughout this pregnancy where I would be laying in my stairwell, waiting on my husband to get home because I couldn't go upstairs, and I wouldn't complain. I would just thank God, crying, tears coming out of my eyes. I would just thank God. One day I was sitting in my bathroom, I was talking to God, and I just felt great peace come over me, great peace come over me. And He said, Crystal, I have to take the baby. And I started crying. And I was like, because it's like something in me knew it was God. I was like, God, why do you have to take my baby? I said, you can heal her. Why do you have to take her? I went to the doctor maybe a few weeks later, and they basically said the same thing. They said, we're seeing something on the scan. We don't know what it is. We're going to send you to a specialist. I started crying because I remember what God said, but at the same time, I wouldn't complain. You know, I was just surrendered to the process, even though it did not feel good. And we ended up going to the specialist, and they confirmed that something was wrong with the baby. She probably wouldn't make it. And they said that her heart was enlarging, so they had to admit me. So they admitted me, and I couldn't go home. I was in the hospital about a week, and basically I gave birth to her. And after I gave birth to her, her name was Jubilee, and she lived a little bit, and after a few hours, she passed away. And I remember sitting in my hospital bed, holding her body. She's no longer living, and I looked up to God, and I said, thank you, Jesus, because I understood. God says, give thanks in everything. So even though I didn't understand it, I had to give thanks. So I just gave thanks to God with tears in my eyes, crying. And since then, God has really restored me. I went through a period of grief. I didn't know how to grieve. So I was like in a low moment, and Satan tried to use this moment to attack me. But God came in and He rescued me, you know? He was with me the whole time. But after this, God taught me how to grieve through me continuing to watch Apostles' teachings, through her speaking exactly what I needed to hear when I needed to hear. It strengthened me to keep going. And since then, at the time, in the beginning, I had lost 75 pounds. But since then, I've lost 104 pounds. God has given me His heart, even more of His heart. He's given me joy. He's given me peace. He's given me a sound mind. What the enemy meant for evil, it did not work. I am stronger. I am bolder. I am courageous. And every time the enemy goes low, I'm thinking of the next way I can go for His kingdom. What can I do, you know, to to destroy the works of the enemy. And even to that, my daughter was diagnosed with autism. She wasn't speaking. I used to cry to God because I wanted her to say, "Mommy, I love you." I wanted her to tell me when she was hungry, what she wanted to eat. She couldn't do any of that. And now she's speaking. She's telling me what she wants to eat. She's calling me mommy. She's saying, "I love you." She used to didn't like to kiss or hold hands. Now she's doing all of that. My son, he had eczema. He was wet in the bed. He's free of that. My husband was addicted to cigarettes. He's free of that. So many miracles God has done in my life in the span of 2.5 years. And I'm so blessed to be planted at His true church. I'm so blessed to have Apostle as my spiritual mother. I'm thankful for her spiritual father, Prophet Jira Davy, for even coming to America and releasing God's anointing. And I'm just so happy. And I just want to say thank you. Thank you to God. Thank you to Apostle. Amen.